Feeling better?
I'd like a drink.
Before breakfast?
Get me a drink!
The role of a once famous actress turned alcoholic and bent on self-destruction came in a film called Dangerous. Her very individual quality could now be seen more clearly.
Why don't you lay off that stuff?
Because I'd rather be drunk than sober.
I gathered that last night.
Last night? Oh, you must be quite proud of your conquest.
You're very wrong. You see, I...
Don't bother with an alibi. It really doesn't matter.
You're a perfect alibi. Take a look at yourself. Take a good look. Drunken, ill-kept. The only feeling you could arouse in a man is pity.
Pity? Pity? You dare feel sorry for me. You with your fat little soul and your smug face, picking your way so cautiously through a pest-hell existence. Well, I've lived more in a day than you'll ever dare live. Pity for me? That's very funny, because I've never had any for men like you.
She was given her first Academy Award for her performance in Dangerous in March 1936. By now, she had been married for 4 years to a band leader called Harmon Oscar Nelson. She was happily married, but still dedicated to her career.
Desire to want something, to obtain that desire and live up to every moment of it. And then go on leaving yesterday behind. On and on, higher and higher. Frustrated actress reads lines for small audience.
After 31 pictures, 2 Academy nominations and 1 Oscar, the parts and the scripts they now offered were making her feel unhappy and unfulfilled. She was bound to Warner's for another 5 years. The contract system had given her security, but no privilege of choice.
Bad scripts, bad directors. Terrible scripts. Bureau of Missing Persons, Parachute Jumper, Housewife. Oh, just junk. And I knew that I would never attain my goal without good scripts and good directors. And so I walked.
She staged a one-woman strike. She sailed across the Atlantic to take up an offer of work in Europe. Warner's stopped her salary, suspended her, and took her to court. The case was heard in London.
Miss Bette Davis is in the headline news over a lawsuit with her Hollywood employers. Newspapers have made a lot of fuss because she wore the same clothes 3 days running, practically in rags.
Since people knew the salaries that Hollywood people got, that mitigated against her winning the case, in my belief. One gets the feeling if somebody's getting in excess of $1,000 a week, they really should put up with anything. However, if their career was being run into the ground, they wouldn't be able to get that money or any money very shortly.
These contracts are written strictly for the studio, not for the actors. And the more powerful an actor got, the more control he tried to exercise over the quality of material offered him. And if so she had fights, so she had fights. But there was a reason behind them. I don't think... She never threw fits without a damn good reason. I don't think so.
I lost the battle, but I won the war.
Warner's paid her share of the damages, and when she returned, gave her a good script, a shrewd director, and a strong supporting cast. The film, Marked Woman, was a story about the New York underworld. Warner Brothers, now known as the Working Man's Studio, were making realistic films with a concern for society's losers, an approach to production which suited Bette Davis well.
I remember Unmarked Woman, when this gang had beaten me up. You heard it off stage. Cut, scar, face. The makeup people came down with the gauze. In those days, there was one bandage for any ailment to the face. Went across here, came down here, and under here. So the entire face was in view. Well, you looked like some kind of a nun. And I knew this was ludicrous, so I said to the director, I'll be back in a little while. I took the studio car, went to my doctor. I said, I've been beaten up hopelessly. So he put big plugs in my nose to be swollen. And well, it was the most marvelous sight you ever saw. And I came through the gate, and the guard at the gate called Mr. Wallace and said, Mr. Wallace, Miss Davis has been in a terrible automobile accident.
You'll feel better now, don't you?
Now, those things I was really one of the first fighters for, because I believe that's what the screen had to offer. Real reality of appearance.
How? By just closing my eyes and pretending it never happened. I wish it was as easy as that, but it isn't.